سبحانك لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك، أنت المقدم وأنت المؤخر، أنت على كل شيء قدير. In the name of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, the most compassionate, the most merciful, all praise and thanks are due to him and peace and blessings be upon his beloved Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. He who is guided by the will of Allah, no one can misguide him, and he who is misguided, no one can guide him except Allah سبحانه وتعالى. I do bear witness that there is no God but Allah and Muhammad is his messenger. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today, inshallah, with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we will be dealing with qawl Allah ta'ala in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 253, which is, تِلْكَ الرُّسُلُ فَضَّلْنَا بَعْضَهُمْ عَلَىٰ بَعْضٍ مِنْهُمْ مَنْ كَلَّمَ اللَّهُ وَرَفَعَ بَعْضَهُمْ دَرَجَاتٍ وَآتَيْنَا عِيسَى بْنَ مَرْيَمَ الْبَيِّنَاتِ وَأَيَّدْنَاهُ بِرُوحِ الْقُدُسِ وَلَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مَا اقْتَتَلَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ من بعد ما جاءتهم البينات ولكن اختلفوا فمنهم من آمن ومنهم من كفر ولو شاء الله ما اقتتلوا ولكن الله يفعل ما يريد. Last time, if you remember, we finished something has to do with the big image of the stories where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us something that related to the story of Goliath, which is Jalut, Saul, Talut, and David or Dawood, alayhi salam. I hope we had a good idea, but the most important thing that whenever, wherever Allah mentions something in the Quran as part of the story, it has been mentioned definitely for what we call al-i'tibar, al-tafakkur, faqsus al-qasas la'allahum yatafakkarun. So we do not do Qasas, stories for entertainment. Plus, always there is a message that is applicable during the history of the time to there, till the end of the time. Because this is a constitution, and keep in your mind. Once Allah decided, subhanahu wa ta'ala, that third of the Quran is Qasas, stories, it's not just for the sake of nothing. Bearing in your mind that the Quran is the constitution of humanity, and it's the miracle of Muslims, and it's the miracle of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and it is the final miracle of Allah to humanity after tens and hundreds and thousands of prophets and miracles physical. This is the only non-physical miracle. And in my own words, I always use just to make it simple, our miracle is data, constitution, software, well designed and programmed. Wherever you download this software into your device or your device, everything will go perfectly. So our devices, I mean by our devices, ourselves, our bodies, our societies, our communities, can operate with different softwares. However, we have best genuine software, and we have any software. It is designed to accept to work with any software, but not with the full capacity and the best function. So ours, our miracle is Quran. Quran is what? Guidance. Contains what? Information, data, guidance, words. Do, don't, say, don't, be careful. 1, 2, 3, 4, guidance. That's why it's a hidayah. So when we speak about the stories, part of this constitution, we need really to keep an eye to understand what's happening and why. After finishing this story of Dawood, Jalut, and Talut with all the messages that we highlighted, look what Allah said, subhanahu wa ta'ala. تِلْكَ الرُّسُلْ لَحَظْ فَضَّلْنَا بَعْضَهُمْ عَلَىٰ بَعْضٍ. Because just few verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was talking about how he favored Dawood alayhi salam. وَأَتَاهُ اللَّهُ الْمُلْكَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ. Allah enabled him, Allah sent Talut, and he gave him the power, the physical power, and the ilm. He led the children of Israel. They won the war against their enemies. At that time, they... Canaanites, the Amalekites, the Philistines at that time, who used to be 3,000 to 500 years ago, they were idol worshippers, paganists, subhanallah. Look how things go, subhanallah. طيب. تلك الرسل فضلنا بعضهم على بعض. Allah says, literally now, we have chosen some of those messengers above others. First message. Allah, let me read the full ayah, then I will go to them. We have chosen some of those messengers above others. Allah spoke directly to some and raised some high in rank. To Jesus, the son of Mary, we gave clear proofs and supported him with the Holy Spirit. If Allah had willed, succeeding generations would not have fought among themselves after receiving the clear proofs. But they differed. Some believed while others disbelieved. Yet, if Allah had willed, they would not have fought one another. But Allah does what He wills. By the way, this ayah alone, I can make a full course on the guidance in this ayah. Full course for 4 months. This ayah just. It's very intensive with guidance. But very quickly. First, تلك الرسل فضلنا بعضهم على بعض. So in Islam, do we believe that Allah has chosen and favored some prophets among themselves above others? Yes. طب واي شيخ؟ None of your business, حبيبي. It's the decision of Allah. Very simple. It is the creation of Allah. We existed by His will. He decided to give a superior status for some people. Period. Don't waste your time. Why win? How? How can I be prophet? You can't. But you can't. No way. It's the decision of Allah. Close the file. Period. نقطة. أول السطر. Finished. We don't have like some others, enlightenment. You go to meditation, they stay 55 years waiting for the, what? Revelation. It will not come, habibi. It's a pure decision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't waste your time. But you can follow the footsteps of the prophets to reach to high status which will satisfy you. Period. Is that complicated? Direct to the point. We don't believe in any prophet after Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whatever, whoever, whenever, unaccepted. Period. طيب تلك الرسل فضلنا بعضهم على بعض. Look, منهم الذين الله سبحانه وتعالى continues. قال منهم من كلم الله. Allah spoke directly to some. How? We don't know. Okay, Sheikh, I want to understand how. We don't know. But I need to know. You will not. Why? Because to realize the how, you need to understand the true nature of Allah. We know about His existence, His power, His attributes, the manifestation of His attributes, His real nature. We have no idea about it. No idea. But how did we know? لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. Nothing resembles. طب بس يعني nothing. Philosophically, academically, whenever, whatever, whoever you try to make resembling with Allah, you are insulting Allah in Islam. You know why? You know why? Because everything in the creation has been created on the base of weakness and defects. Everything. That is the meaning. يعني, one of the best of the creation, human beings. We are best than the stones, we are best than the sun, we are best than the trees and the soil and the dust. Type. We, whom are supposed to be one of the best of the creation, we are based on defects and weakness. خلق الإنسان ضعيفة. يعني, what is the philosophical point? Philosophical points, we can't live full dependent on ourselves. So therefore it's a weakness point. يعني, can any child live without the breastfeeding of his mother? No. Death directly. طيب. Can we live without oxygen? Water, food, sleeping, going to washroom? Can you live without food and going to the washroom? You, me, I, we, are in need to the washroom, to the toilet. This is a weakness, a defect. This is the meaning of Allah as-Samad. You know as-Samad? قال القائم بذاته غير المحتاج لغيره. As-Samad means the one who is fully dependent on himself does not need anything else. We always are in need for someone or something. This is called weakness, defects. That's why when you resemble Allah with anything, someone or something, you are insulting Allah. Because you are comparing the full perfection with the, what? The non-perfect. That's why when someone says Allah looks like XYZ or someone looks like Allah, it's kufr in Islam. Direct to the point. So, that I'm explaining وكلم الله, the how we don't know. Forget it, خلاص. Allah managed. But some people keep insisting and nagging on this point. But I need to know the how. If I challenge you that you yourself now in your scientific daily based life, 90% of what you deal with, you don't know the how. True or false? Simple, simple, humble example. دين موبايل تبعك معلش بعد إذنك. Do you use this device? Do we use it or not? What do you call it? Mobile cell phone, صح? How do we communicate with others depending on that? Based on what? What is the signal? Do we use the, what do we call the waves? Type. Who saw the wave? Who saw the signal? Who can give me an idea about the taste, the color, the weight, the speed, the shape of the signal or the wave? تفضل, يلا. How come you use it and you don't know all of these kind of very important details? Wow. How come you use this without understanding these simple things? You don't know the how. Who saw the electron? Proton, electron, neutron, speaking. Because they exist now in the light. Did you see them? Do you know the exact how? No. Yet you use it. So I had a simple example. Go to electricity. By the way, do we use electricity? Have you witnessed the electricity itself? Itself, electricity. Where is it now? Where is the electricity? Now, where is it? Is this light electricity? Is it electricity? No, the light is not. The light is one of the effects of electricity, of the existence of electricity. But what is it? Where is it? It does exist. Where is it? Hiya, in the wires, habibi. Where is it? Touch it. Go and speak with it. Have a conversation and ask it about its nature, habibi. Yalla, tfadr. Wallah, I'm not joking. And by the way, I'm dealing with physics and science now. Yet, we will have so arrogant people. As long as we are not able to realize the nature of Allah, how come we believe in Him, Sheikh? Habibi, when you realize the nature of electricity and the signal of your mobile, come and discuss with me. Wallahi, I'm not joking. This is the arrogance of the human beings. So, forget to interfere or to be able to know the reality of Allah. But is this something ultimate? No. In the day of judgment, let me continue this specific comment. Allah says, وجوه يومئذٍ ناظرة النظر. Happy, smiling, cheerful, full of happiness. Why? إلى ربها ناظرة. We will be witnessing Allah. How? I don't know. But in the day of judgment, Allah will recreate us in a new bodies, new shapes. Be careful. It's now our souls, they are created before our existence. Then your soul, which has been created, Allah knows, millions, trillions, billions, thousands, we don't know. This soul will be injected in the womb of your mother when you start be a living being on this earth. Up to the death, the soul will leave this. It's like a space suit. Take off. Now you will go with your soul to a third phase, which is عالم البرزخ, which contains the pleasure of the qabr, نعيم القبر, and the punishment of the qabr. In the day of judgment, we believe in resurrection congregation, ba'ath wa nushur, new created bodies for our same souls, same memory, same feelings, same realizing, a new what? Shape. Then we have the existence, inshallah, in the Jannah. In the Jannah, we will be equipped with new extra added values, abilities. How did we discover that? For example, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Hadith Sahih, he said that we will be eating in the Jannah food out of pleasure, not out of hunger. We don't sleep, we don't feel tired. طيب, here, our bodies are designed and created. We eat, we have to go to the washroom. There, we eat, food comes out of our skins. المسامات, you hear in English? المسامات. P-O-R-E-S, pores. الجمع. جمع pores. You know, the outcome in this dunya, basically, we have to go to the washroom. In the Jannah, the outcome will be a perfume will come out of the pores, which means a new design. We will eat, we will enjoy, but the fruit, the food, ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلبي. Completely something new. We know just the names. طيب. Here, if we don't sleep, we can't be energetic. There, you don't sleep. No tiredness. طيب. Here, we have hot weather because of the sun. And we have cold weather. There, you don't have hot or cold. You have just a light and enjoyment. How? Part of this new abilities, we will be equipped with a sight. We will be able to see Allah. We don't know the how. Can you tell me how now we cannot see the X-ray? By the way, do we use the Bluetooth here? Yes or no? IR, infrared. Do we use it or not? Can we see it? No. طب X-ray. Do we believe that it does exist? X-ray. We always go to the you know, to the labs to have the X-ray for our chest and our bones and the it does exist, but we don't see it. We don't see it. This is that's why we they call it even the sounds ultra infra, which is above the ability of the sight and the hearing, below the ability, which means Allah is able to what used to be above and below to be included. It's the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now I can't see the angels. I will be able to see the angels. What's the evidence? فَكَشَفْنَا عَنْكَ غِطَاءَكَ فَبَصَرُكَ الْيَوْمَ حَدِيدٌ. We will uncover the cover, the limitation of your sights, realization. Can we see viruses now? Can we see angels? We can't. Unless if we're using an extra tools, we will have an ability. We will realize part, full, the reality of Allah, we don't know. But Allah said, we will be witnessing. إِلَى رَبِّهَا نَاظِرًا. I'm just referring to the concept of the idea of choosing and favoring some prophets above others. Okay? Now, we will continue. قال وآتينا عيسى بن مريم بالبينات وأيدناه بروح القدس. Now, to Jesus, son of Mary, we gave clear proofs and supported him with the Holy Spirit. Now, we have something simple and something a little bit tricky we need to highlight. Two messages here. Part of our faith, which is something basic for us, that Jesus Christ, the son of Mary, is what? In Islam? Prophet and messenger, human being. Now, Christians, they believe he is God's incarnate, he is God himself, or he is the son of God regardless, which is what is called the Trinity. It's completely in Islam unacceptable and rejected. No room to have something in the middle. It's completely rejected, okay? you can't have something in the middle. Because you can't consider a man that a God and and a man. It's unacceptable in Islam. Actually, if you believe in this, you will be outside of the fold of Islam. So for us, he is just a prophet and messenger. And we believe, and I'm not discussing now how, when, what's the proof, but we believe that he gave the good news and the glad tidings about the coming of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We believe in that. And if you are interested to read about this, read about the concept of Parakletos, or Al-Farakleet, the Parakletos. If you are interested and you have time to read in English or in Arabic, I'm not sure if it's in Urdu, go to the book of David Benjamin Kildani, who became, after reverting to Islam, Abdul Ahad Dawood. He was a Catholic, high rank priest in Catholicism in Iraq about 120 years ago, before the collapse of the Ottoman Empire. And he used to speak 5 to 7 languages perfectly. And he used to have manuscripts in Latin, Greek, Hebrew. And he used to read and write Arabic, English, French, Latin, Greek, and Hebrew. Subhanallah, after a long journey and a lot of discussions with Muslim scholars in the Ottoman Empire at that time, he decided to become a Muslim. And he wrote 5 books. One of them is Muhammad in the Bible. It's a piece of art. But by the way, it's a very, very, very intensive book. But if you are interested in this context, in this thing, please have an idea. David Benjamin Kildani, Abdul Ahad Dawood. The book was written originally, to the best of my knowledge, in English, and it was translated into Arabic. We have 2 translations for this book, by Hamdi Rida and Fahmi Shamma. Hamdi Rida, Fahmi Shamma. Fahmi Shamma is a revert as well. His translation is much, much, much better than Hamdi Rida, both of them in Arabic. Anyway, why I'm mentioning this book? Because he was a professional expert in manuscripts. He proved in this book how Muhammad in nowadays manuscripts is still mentioned. And the name that is in the Greek, Latin, then Latin word is Parakletos. Parakletos in Hebrew, the Muhammadinim, which is Al-Muhammad Al-Mahmud. It's translated in Arabic among Christians as Al-Mu'azzi, and they translate it as Holy Spirit, which is part of Trinity. It's a long story. This is a very deep, deep discussion, if you are interested. I don't know if some of you are interested in comparative religions. I gave you just the link to start reading about this. But for us, Jesus Christ is a prophet and messenger, and he gave the glad tidings about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is part of our faith. Now the idea, قال وأيدناه بروح القدس. For us, روح القدس, the Holy Spirit is, definitely is, Jibril alayhi salam. Archangel Gabriel, period. Now, Holy Spirit has completely another definition in the Christian mentality. It is part of the Trinity. Okay? Trinity, they believe in the concept of Trinity. Now, you may ask me to explain Trinity to you. If you can find a professional Christian priest can explain it to you, please you explain it to me. I'm not joking. Seriously. No one is able to explain it. Who understands what Trinity is? Anyway, but this is part of the Trinity because some people, they think when Christians speak about Holy Spirit, they are talking about Jibril. No, they are talking as something part of the concept of Trinity. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit in the Christian understanding is not Jibril alayhi salam. It's something has to do with their faith. To the best of my knowledge, no one is able to understand the reality of it. But this is not my topic now. But for us, whenever Ruh al-Qudus is mentioned in our context, we are talking about the Archangel Gabriel, Jibril alayhi salam. Okay? Because sometimes some of missionary groups, when they start discussing with Muslim people who have no knowledge about Islamic context, sometimes they use some verses out of context. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, وَرُوحٌ مِنْهِ, that the spirit of Isa alayhi salam is مِنْهِ. Now, this attribution, this nisbah, is applicable to all of us. We all have spirits. Don't we have spirits? Arwah, arwahuna. Who created the spirit? Allah. My ruh, your ruh, his ruh, her ruh, all of our arwah are created by Allah. It's attributed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, exactly like Isa alayhi salam. Period. That's it. It's very easy in Islam. But just to put you in the context, what Allah mentioned in this ayah, وَأَيَّدْنَاهُ بِرُوحِ الْقُدُسِ. طيب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue, اللهم صلى الله عليه سيدنا محمد. In this context, it's good to know we are living in an environment which might be full of Christian brothers and sisters, our brothers and sisters in the humanity. Many of them, they are not educated about Islamic understanding for faith. Many of them, they don't know what we believe in. And I advise you, when a Christian asks you about Islam, please be patient, because they have a lot of misunderstanding about us. Explain to them what we believe. One of the excellent and most beautiful things that you must tell them, and they need to know it, how do we look at Virgin Mary alayhi salam, and how do we look at Isa alayhi salam? Respect. Even though we have a dispute in faith, and even though at the very beginning Prophet Muhammad was attacked by Christian Romans and by Arab Romans, sorry, by Arab Christian, which is Al-Ghassasin al-Manadhira. Tabuk and Mu'ta was against who? Protecting themselves from the attack of Arab Christians and Roman Christians. Yet, the Quran contains a special surah about Maryam alayhi salam. We don't have a special surah for Khadija. We don't have a special surah for Fatima. We don't have a special surah for Aisha. No special surah for Abu Bakr. But we have special surah, not just about Mary, protecting her chastity and dignity and reputation against those who attacked her reputation, alayhi salam. Are you with me? So you need to convey this information, because they don't know. Because for many political reasons, for many conflict reasons, some of people in charge, especially in the mainstream media, they do their best to tell others lies about us. Many of them, they don't know that we have this kind of very beautiful picture about Isa alayhi salam. And he's mentioned many times in the Quran, highly praised. And Maryam alayhi salam, the most beloved females to our Prophet, they are not mentioned, nor by their names. And even Aisha, when it's mentioned in the context of protecting her against attacking her reputation. And the most important thing in this context, that the Quran was not composed by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because if it was his decision, logically, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was attacked by Christian Romans and Arab Christians. True or false? If the book is his, why on earth he will praise the most important two figures in Christianity? Jesus and Mary. Logically. Romans, they want to get rid of him. Arab Christians, they want to get rid of him. They are attacking him. If you were him, are you going to think to put a special chapter praising the most two important figures in the religion of your enemy? Logically speaking, it's impossible. But what about your beloved ones? No one is mentioned. But your ankle, تَبَّتْ يَدَا أَبِي لَهَبَ أَتَبْ, he's in the hellfire. لا إله إلا الله. What kind of composed book is this? If it was the production of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, why on earth he will mention these things? By the way, this is a common things when you speak with others. But because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, وَأَتَيْنَا عِيسَى بْنَ مَرْيَمَ الْبَيِّنَاتِ وَأَيَّدْنَاهُ بِرُوحِ الْقُدُسِ. Now Allah continues, وَلَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مَقْتَتَلَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَتْهُمُ الْبَيُّنَاتُ وَلَكِنْ اخْتَلَفُوا فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ آمَنَ وَمِنْهُمْ من كفر ولو شاء الله ما اقتتلوا. If Allah had willed, succeeding generations would not have fought among themselves. Now, as if the Quran is referring to what happened after, you know, thus many prophets after them, including Musa alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam, after them, Jews themselves, they became many groups. Christians themselves, they became many groups. And Muslims themselves, now they have a lot. So all times and generations, they fought each other, dispute and fought. Allah is talking about what we call the divine law of Sunnat al-Ikhtilaf. And the will of Allah to allow this to happen as part of the test. يعني ولو شاء الله ما اختلفوا. If Allah had will, they would not. Allah allowed, which means part of our existence, الذي خلق الموت والحياة لي يبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. Part of your test that you will have the knowledge, the ability, the tools, the عقل, the reasoning, the feelings, the ability to take an ethical decision, faith-based decision. You know the law, you know the rights and the wrong, and it's your decision to accept or to submit yourself to your desire, to your feelings, to your aql, to your reasoning, and to hukum of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this test, dispute. So, as if Allah telling us, be careful. Don't keep asking why they differ. Allah allowed this to happen as part of the test. Close the file. Do your best in this fight to be in the best status. Don't keep asking why they differ, but ask yourself, do your best to be in the high ethical standard status while this differentiation or fighting or dispute happening at any time. وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ. By this, قال, yet, I will finish it, read it as a final time, then I will finish, inshallah. If Allah had willed, succeeding generations would not have fought among themselves after receiving the clear proofs. Be careful. بعد ما جاءتهم بينات. Allah is telling that the بينات, the clear proofs, they are known. Yet we differ. This gives you an idea that dispute and fighting is not necessarily because the truth is not clear. يعني, give me a simple example. What happens now is in Palestine, logically, if you completely detach yourself from any kind of interest, political interest, any kind of affiliation with any interest, is it complicated to know who's right and who's wrong? Is it complicated? It's very, very, very obvious, yet debate after debate and discussion, because we have what? Interests behind fabrication, lies, okay, fake news. But you know, Allah ya Sheikh, forget what's happening now. The vast majority of Arab regimes and Arab leaders, don't they know that they are not applying Islam? Do they know or they don't know? Are they aware that in many cases they are doing injustice when torturing their people or not? They know. I mean, in terms of understanding, they know it's clear proof. But one of the very, very simple evidences on this, anyone from the followers and supporters of these regimes, whenever he's kicked out, he starts criticizing them. True or false? When he's out, خلاص, he's expired, they kick him out. He was a high rank in the army, high rank in the intelligence forces, whatever. Expired, خلاص. You've done your job, you're out, habibi. When he's out, no lights on, no prestige, no power, no money, no whatever, he start what becomes? Mu'arada. You know? He start becoming what? Objections. He rejects, he attacks, he criticizes the oppression. But just last year you were with them and you were defending all of this. Did not you realize back then? Wallah, I realized, but ya Sheikh, you know. يعني يا شيخ, يعني, you know, I know what? You were a hypocrite, you were a liar. And you will see what you deserve in this dunya and in the akhirah, inshallah. So realize, but I mean, my point, من بعد ما جاءتهم البينات. So be careful. The haqq is clear. The ikhtilaf is not because Allah is misleading the people. No, the clear is there. It's my problem and your problem. Because I decide I want this side because I want to achieve some personal interest or whatever interest. Exactly. قال, after receiving clear proofs, but they differed. Some believed while others disbelieved. Yet, if Allah had willed, they would not have fought one another, but Allah does what He wills. And the best example that I have repeated at least maybe 100 times, let's make it 101 times now. Mr. Abu Jahl. It's a very good example. Was he ignorant about who is Muhammad? فبلاش أبو جهل أبو لهب. Was he aware who's Muhammad or not? يا الله. His uncle, his nephew. He knows exactly. أبو جهل himself, he was asked by many ex-Muslims, ex-mushrikeen, they used to be with him. When they converted to Islam, they started telling what used to happen in their secret conversation between them and Abu Jahl. When they drink together, having their gatherings, meetings, they say, Ya Abu al-Hakam, because his title was Abu al-Hakam, Amr ibn Hisham. He say, Abu al-Hakam, you know, he was drinking, he say, Ya Abu al-Hakam, أَوَلَا تَعْلَمُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدٌ النَّبِيِّ. يعني, hey, between you and me, while sipping some kind of alcohol, he say, Abu al-Hakam, between you and me, يعني, don't you know that Muhammad is a genuine prophet? He say, I know. قَلْ بَلَا أَعْلَمُ. طب if you know يعني why you don't follow him from a tribal ethnic racist point of view بنو مخزوما بنو هاشم قال أطعموا فأطعمنا سقوا فسقينا كسوا فكسينا فجاء منهم نبي فأنا لنا بذلك. It's a pure racist tribal mentality, which means I belong to X group, he belongs to another group in the tribal mentality. They did, we did. They did, we did. They did, we did. They were competing in, you know, the high prestigious attitude towards the Kaaba among the paganist Arabs. You know, at'amu, they used to feed and to bring drink and to take care of the pilgrims and all of these things. قال فجاء منهم نبي. Out of a sudden, a prophet came. How can we bring a prophet? We can't afford it. Okay, what is your final decision? I will fight him. But you know that he's genuine. I know, but I will fight him. لا إله إلا الله. Some people might say, no, that's impossible. Yes, impossible, Habibi. Mr. Iblis is the best example. I keep repeating Iblis as well. Iblis, he was an eyewitness on the creation of Adam. Iblis Allah did not test Iblis in what we are tested in terms of علم الغيب. What is علم غيب for us is shahada for him. He was there, sitting there, witnessing the creation of Adam. And he was addressing Allah, Rabbi, bima khalaqtani, my Lord, as you created me. طيب يلا تفضل, اسجد. قال أنا خير, I'm better. No. So was his problem ignorance? No. The unseen? No. Uncertainty? No. What was it? Kibr, arrogance. So please keep this in your mind. So the idea is not knowing and not knowing the haqq and batil. No. We have something else. This is like, but just a reminder about understanding. من بعد ما جاءتهم البينات. This is very important. After they received the clear proofs. صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. See you inshallah next time. Be careful. Now, next week inshallah, by the will of Allah. In the same time of the session, we will not have a tafsir session. We will have a special ceremony to celebrate giving the full ijazah for four hafiz, inshallah, here. They did the full ijazah. Sheikh Abdul Aziz will be coming with a number of hafaz, and we will be giving them the sanad, and they asked me to be one of the witnesses on the certificates by the narration of sanad to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We will be submitting them in front of all of you, inshallah, next week here, exactly in this time, okay? So please come and bring your brothers, your sisters, your families, let them witness how, you know, the barakah, the blessings of receiving you know, the sanad, the certificate of assurance of having the full hifz of the Quran to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam by four hafizs, inshallah. Okay, next time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.